Welcome to Desert Succulent. Today we're going to be talking a very important topic, which is all about rainwater and our succulents. We all know that our succulents and cacti are drought loving, and if for example we're going to be leaving them outside in the rain, we might panic thinking na magkaroon sila ng ating root rot, since yung ating excess moisture nga is one of the succulent's worst enemy. It's normal that we're gonna be thinking that way, pero there is really nothing much to worry about kasi yung ating mga rainwater, they can actually be quite healthy for our succulents, even in large amounts. Moreover, there are also some few factors such as yung ating drainage, yung soil na ginamit natin, yung temperature kung saan sila located. So these things are something that we need to consider before worrying about our succulents this rainy season. If your succulents are located sa ating rain or shine area like I do, yung konting pag-ulan won't really harm yung ating mga succulents and cacti as well. But also, a lot of rain can also be beneficial to them kasi as a general rule nga, diba, succulents prefer nga yung ating infrequent but deep watering, and yung ating heavy rainfall might be what our plants need to look even better after a long period na hindi natin sila diniligan. I prefer na naulanan yung ating mga succulents kasi yung ating rainwater as compared with our tap water galing sa ating faucet, they don't contain any additives such as yung ating chlorine or the fluoride, kasi itong ating mga additives na to are intended to make nga yung ating water safe for human consumption, but they are not actually ideal for our plants. In addition na walang minerals and additive content yung ating ulan, yung ating rainwater would na also provide our succulents yung cleansing na shower, kasi pag umulan, it will wash away the dirt and dust na nag-collect sa leaves ng ating mga succulents, and therefore, if that happens, it would now allow the leaves better access to our sunlight. This is something that we can do occasionally kasi ayaw rin naman natin na mag-collect yung water sa leaves or sa pinaka-rosette ng ating succulent kasi eventually, it could lead to rot. We can understand that yung ating rainwater is not readily available all throughout the year, and sometimes we can also make use of our tap water as our last option. However, in my case, I also choose to collect rainwater to nourish nga yung ating mga succulents in the future kasi hindi naman talaga umuulan every day. And probably if you're gonna be collecting your water, make sure na yung container ninyo is clean enough so that you can store yung ating rainwater for at least 2 weeks time. Pag masyado naman nating na-store yung ating rainwater, the problem is magiging stagnant siya, and instead that our succulent can receive the benefits of rainwater, baka mas mapasama pa sila since yung ating rainwater has been stored for a long period of time already. One of the biggest impact on whether or not our succulents will survive a heavier rain, lalo na ngayon na monsoon rains, dire-diretso talaga ang pag-uulan, is the type of soil kung saan sila nakatanim. Typically, yung ating mga succulents prefer yung ating coarse or well-draining na soil mix. If yung kanilang soil will now hold too much moisture for too long, the plant's roots will likely rot or mabubulok talaga sila. And on the other hand, if we planted our succulents in the right type of soil, then we should have little to worry about. Sometimes, if yung ating mga succulents are in puddles, it would not give them the risk of root rot, so it's best nga to avoid leaving yung ating mga pots or containers on the ground kasi pag talagang umulan, like what you can see here, talagang nagko-collect yung water, and therefore hindi talaga nag-drain thoroughly yung ating tubig from the pot kasi yung pinakailalim niya is also covered with water, and therefore we have to consider placing our pots on an elevated surface such as yung ating mga tables or shelf or anywhere kung saan sila pwedeng ilagay. While yung ating mga succulents typically prefer yung climates na may limited na rainfall, it's also possible na palakihin sila and alagaan sila in a more rainy environments such as here in the mountains. dito sa Benguet area and also sa lowland areas, hindi rin tayo ligtas dito nga sa ating mga monsoon rains or yung hanging habagat. Since we are already aware na talagang yearly we have this rainy season, we also need to properly prepare our succulents. You also need to keep a close eye or monitor nga yung ating mga weather forecast so that we can make the right decisions for our setup. Syempre pag sinabi sa weather report na magiging maulan nga, like for example right now we have the monsoon rains na possibly 2 weeks or 3 weeks siyang magtatagal, then therefore we can prepare in moving yung ating mga succulents in a shaded area, or we can also cover them with any plastic sheets that you have or any material that you have para lang i-protect sila against the rain. Yung ating mga succulents that are planted in pots are the easiest to prepare kasi pwede natin silang ipasok indoors anytime. What I have here are some of my succulents na ayaw ko talaga silang nauulanan, and therefore I try to gather them and just put them here indoors until nga yung ating panahon would be better. Meanwhile, yung ating mga succulent outdoors are a little more difficult to protect from the rain unless you really have that kind of greenhouse na would keep them dry for a long period of time. What I have here is just a DIY na greenhouse. It won't be that sturdy. Hindi siya ganun katibay, but it serves its purpose of protecting yung aking mga succulents against the rain. There are times na hinahangin itong ating plastic cover sa loob, and so I decided nga to secure itong ating plastic cover na ito since we're just experiencing heavy rainfall and wala naman masyadong malakas na hangin, unlike pag bumabagyo talaga. Kapag malakas yung ulan, it's very difficult for us to check on our succulents. Like for example, in my case, it's an open area and nakalagay pa sila sa ating rooftop, and therefore the only time I can go and check on them is pagkatapos ng ating ulan, and there I have realized those mistakes that I did. Like what we have here, yung ating morning beauty na succulent na nakalagay nga into this glass na container. So if wala silang drainage holes, we should not be putting them in this area. Dapat ito nakalagay indoors, but that's actually one of the mistakes that I did. Hindi ko siya natanggal in this area before pa man din umulan, but nevertheless still yung ating morning beauty is very healthy. Probably more than a week na din siyang nakasoak dito sa kanyang glass container, and I'm really glad na okay pa naman siya, although sa pinakailalim na part napakadami niya ng leaves na nabulok, and yung kanyang mga roots I'm gonna try na patuyuin siya kasi parang nabubulok na yung ibang parts. Yung ating mga pots na nakalagay sa ating mga saucers, it's gonna be expected na mas matagal ding mag-dry out yung kanilang soil after a heavy rain, kaya we need to empty itong ating mga saucer na to of any standing water for us to provide a faster na pagkatuyo ng ating soil. If our succulent is well watered and the leaves are turning yellow and they are mushy and swollen, or sometimes they are even looking this na parang nabubulok na siya, it means that they are over watered already, or they are receiving huge amounts of water na hindi na nila ma-handle ito, and therefore we need to act quickly and do something. If we suspect that our plant is being overwatered because of this continuous na pag-uulan, we need to put it in an area kung saan hindi siya mababasa for at least 2 weeks or even more. It would now depend kung gaano kabilis mag-dry yung kanyang pinaka-soil. If we think na yung ating mga succulents are not in their good condition, we need to uproot them right away kasi nga if we're gonna be waiting for the symptoms to appear on the plant above, it could be too late and hindi na natin ito may iwasan, like what happened to these kind of succulents. The bottom line is we need to prepare in advance before the rainy season would come. If for example you are in a flood prone area, then you have to move them in an elevated na area temporarily. If they are located outdoors na talagang open area and they will be exposed to the rain, you can always set up a temporary or permanent na greenhouse for them. And that's all for our rainy season care guide. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You may also visit our Facebook page at Desert Succulent PH.